All right, yo, we're at the San Jose Regional. Oh. What's your name? What'd you play?
My name's Noel. I play Sky Striker today. I went X1. Apparently, the person that I did lose to, I'm pretty sure they're getting accused of cheating right now. And low-key, that guy did, he did do a search with nothing in deck. I didn't call it because I'm not being a dick. And all right, let's get started then.
All right, yeah. What'd you play?
So we're running 3 Kagari right here. Three Eaglin. Do I have to explain these? I mean, like,
not
the
really.
Ratios. Everybody plays that. I mean, why wouldn't you? You play one of Hayate and one of Kaina. They're pretty nuts. Mm-hmm. I kind of ran out of like the Sky Striker jokes, so I'm gonna tell them the whatever the rest of the names are.
Yeah.
Of course, standard. I like 2 because I just been playing 2, and I didn't want to change it up and change my playstyle. So it was fine. It was great. I've resolved Empin multiple times. I've resolved 2 Empin on the same turn multiple times, and it's really good. It just got me a card advantage. And I don't know if it's just like the card advantage was good, or the people were just like, oh my god, this guy has like 7 cards in hand. just scoop. I don't know. It could be a combination of those things. And then standard. Of course, shifter was standard. I saw this most of the games, except like the top cut games. Except again, I think I saw it against Mike. But that's it. And then I didn't see it at all for the rest of the top cut. Top tables, but it was really good. I mean, why wouldn't you play it, you know?
Yeah,
it's just
straight up steals games.
Yeah, and then terraforming, I made that change because of Gino. It came up so much. Of course, that one I like playing this as well. It came up a lot against like Eldritch.
Oh, you main duster. That's interesting.
This was just another little deck thinner because these were the 2 additional cards. I forget what I took out, but it's 40 cards, so
okay.
It makes it like somewhat 20,
like as consistent
cards.
As possible.
Yeah, as consistent as possible. One of these, because you know it's great, and also it lets me dig for all my side deck cards, which is really good. And also for all the back row decks, it just kept tributing stuff. That's what it does. I mean,
that's literally what it does.
Read the card. Map. What does map do? Shouts out to that guy who was cheating, and he said, like, oh, let me read map hella times.
Then
we got 3. We got 3 Eagle Booster. It was so good. It helped me play Tikaboo as well. Like, it was just so good. What else can I say about it? I mean, that's why you can play the deck, because it lets you search stuff. And also, like, I got drooled maybe 3 times, and just I add another card, and I play under that.
Yeah.
It's great. Lancia as well.
Did you win off of it in time at all?
Never. If I won the game, I won them like decidedly, and I got out early.
Yeah, so, that's good. That's good.
Prosperity, Duality. They're good. You know, consistency. Dig 9 is great. And this is what I chose to put last minute. I mean,
Dark Roller.
That's debatable. Yeah. Like, you know, it lets you break a board, just kind of blink a board.
Yeah.
And then this is the only other hand trap I played because I needed something extra, and it's also good. It's good on the play, so you can just like blink out one card that you know is gonna be.
You can pick the one card that is like problematic.
Yeah, or set it. I mean, it's just I was debating like between these two, and I just decided to just choose both because like if you go first, it's just like okay, cool, these are cool, but I mean like they don't do anything, you know. Obviously,
yeah,
you can set these. Except one game, I drew 3 of them, and I just summoned the eagle. I got Ash, and I'm like, all right, let's just set these. Uh-huh. I mean, that happens. You know?
Yeah, it does happen.
What's this last card? Oh, yeah, this one.
Of course.
And then the side, let's go through it real quick.
Yeah, for sure.
This was really good against the Adventure and Engine, you know. Mm-hmm. I think maybe like only one game, but I think this is probably the MVP of like the whole
okay, anti-spell.
Yeah. Because decided like Twin Twister or anything against me. It's like either Lightning Storm or they're just like, let me just try to push through with Adventure Engine.
Yep.
And then just like, all right, let me just flip this. It was great.
Yeah, that's sick.
This, I've only saw it once against DDD. Surprisingly, I called Exeed. I didn't even do a Pendulum because he like went to like 2 different Exeed. I'm like, all right, you ain't gonna Zeus me, son. No. No thanks. Twin was great. Shout out to my last opponent. He was really cool. But I had let me just show you this other card. I just played this a second one.
Oh wow! Yeah, okay,
He's playing Eldritch. It's really good for like the mirror match, and also like any back row deck because you know obviously you want to see it. You can just tribute stuff. But I kept using this to dig. He had me under Tikaboo and Skill Drain, so I just kept normal summoning my bird with no effect. I did the banished effect first and then chained it with what's it called? On field effect.
Oh, yeah.
If he had Yen or whatever, I just wanted to add more cards so I could just try to mulligan. Mm-hmm. And I drew into Twin twice, and then, like, I did. Anthony Cicella, I am a teacher.
Nine long rounds of Swiss. We have our final standings.
Okay.
Nice.
Yeah.
At this time, our judges are posting final standings.
Hey, yo.
Hey, yo.
Hey, yo.
Hey, yo.
We're in deck profile here, Sam.
Okay. Yeah, so like, shout out to him. But, I had to keep digging. I did two twins once, and then the last play was just mulligan for one because I only had one other bird, and I just wanted to keep the engine going.
Yep.
And then just drew into Harpies. It was great. We'll definitely just keep that in. These are just the last two. This, you know, you can just search that.
One scroll, yeah. And then the reboot.
And Red Reboot.
Yeah.
Red Reboot's sick. That's it. Oh, my bad. No, hold up. The extra decks is actually kind of important,
okay,
too.
Okay.
Oh, shoot. I forgot. This is kind of cool because, like, you can suck something up. I mean, shout out to... Let's go. What is the miscommunication? Let's go. Come on. I knew that guy.
Shout out to Anthony.
Anthony. Stop. Link your Evo because...
That's funny.
I just kept one of these because it's just a link one. There's a time where I was under Tikaboo and I really wanted to play this, so I put that in because you can just summon this with a bird, use map effect as normal, summon another one, and you can go to any one of the charmers. And you can summon usually dark, and then at that point they probably use their DPE and then just summon their DPE. Yep. It's pretty sick.
Yep.
Also, Final Sugma was pretty bad to play against, so. You know, I just played this because it's just this only requires a link two, and usually
insane.
they're not going to negate this. They're going to be like, oh, maybe they're link three
or link four.
It's just a link.
It's literally just a dude.
It's just a 3,000 when he's attacking.
That's genius.
In fourth place with 24 points, Noel Arau.
Let's go! First, better than Brian Chen.
Brian Chen.
Let's go! Brian, where are you?
In sixth place with 22 points.
Stop, Anthony.
Zachary Bishop Stone.
Let's go, Andy.
This is the best deck profile ever.
22
that's
points.
This is.
Woo! Let's go, Calvin. Okay, so where are we at? So the rest is just kind of like more removal. This hasn't come up. Like I theorized it how it could come up, but it didn't have to, which I'm glad because it requires a lot of brain cells.
Yeah.
Nightmare Phoenix, Unicorn, you know, if it ever happens. Never did, but they look nice, and I'm like, let me play them.
yeah, the CRs, I see that.
The last edition I made like is just Selene, because you could just go into Selene with
off of the charmers,
any of the charmers,
right?
And then you can also summon your... shifter from my hand.
Oh, shifters is so casting.
Yeah. So it's pretty good, and then just access what code. Hasn't gone anything.
That's insane.
And then Underworld Goddess, it was really good. It's pretty good.
That's awesome, dude.
Yeah, I had four monsters on the field, and I'm like, let me go into this dude right here, Assemble Nightingale. But yeah, as well as Nightingale, you know, the whole little package.
Uh-huh.
Shouts out King Kong, bro. Like, I keep complaining to Chris, bro. Like, Chris, I don't get any ulties, bro. And Chris is just like, let me put the sauce on you. Rob hasn't touched these at all. and then since then, bro, always get that many ulties.
That's nice, though. That's super nice. Some of, like, the nicest looking ulties.
That's pretty much it.
All right. Any shout-outs?
Shouts out to my dog, Ray, because she's super cool.
Oh, there's Ray.
There's Ray. She's super cute.
Wish she could have been here today.
Yeah, I wish so. Shout out to my girl. I mean, she like supports me playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And just do whatever I love doing. So, yeah, that and my mom too, because I used to always buy cars and they go to her house. And my family. Shout out to all the guys right here, bro.
Let's
turn
go.
The camera around. Look at Danny.
Let's go.
I got 69. Yeah.
Woo!
And a final shout out to Brian Chen. Brian, if you're watching this, just know that you finished behind me and you tried really hard.
Oh. Oh my god. Okay,
thank you
all right. Thank you very much.